Namaste, dear students. First of all, I want to welcome you to our English class of grade 6. I have already told you that your course has been changed. So we are studying new course in grade 6. In our previous class, we learned about professions and their jobs. We talked about teacher and his job. We talked about doctor and his jobs and many more professions and jobs we discussed. Now, we are going to talk about a person. You have to guess who he is, what he does, what his profession is, you know. Everything you will know later on. So, for that one, first of all, I want to show you a picture. And I will ask you a few questions. And based on that one, you will have to make a guess what we are going to learn today. Okay? So, for it, I hope you might be already ready with your necessary materials. They are your English textbook, exercise book, and a pen or a pencil. And if you haven't got your textbook, don't worry. I am here to help you. So all of you, be ready. Are you ready? Good. Now, I want to show you the picture. Please look at it. Look at the picture. So, have you seen the picture there? So, who is he? Who is there in the picture? Man or woman? Yes, there's a man. Do you know his name? Maybe not. So, for that one, you will know later. You have to watch and listen to me very carefully. Okay? Now, I want to ask you a few questions first. Number A, what does a poet do? Now, poet. In our previous class also, we talked about the profession poet and his job. So, what is the profession here? Poet. And what does he do? Another question. Can you name some Nepali poets? Do you know the names of some Nepalese poets? We have written poem in our Nepali language. All right, you can just think and you can tell me later. And another question for you is, who is the man in the picture? Now, you have to tell me the name of this man shown you in the picture. Can you? Let's try. Think about those questions and please try to tell me. Okay, what does a poet do? Yes, you are right, because we have already discussed and learned about the profession poet and his job. The poet writes the poems. Okay, fine, good answer. Now, second question, also I think easy for you. Can you name some Nepali poets? You have to tell me at least 3 Nepali poets' name. Who are they? For example, you can say Lakshmi Prasad Devkota. So, other 2 more names you have to tell me. I want to hear a bit loudly, please. Yes, another Lekhnath Paudel. You are right. And tell me 1 more. Okay, you are right again. Bhanu Bhakta Acharya. Like this, you can add many names in your list. Okay, that's good. Now, the third question for you is, who is the man in the picture? Do you know who is he? What is his profession? What is his job? Can you guess? From the first question, you can make a guess that the person shown in the picture is a poet. Okay? Poet. So if he is a poet, then what is his job? What is his work? Yes, you are right again. His job is composing poems, writing poems. Yes, your wonderful answer. So, based on this one, it means today we are going to learn about the same person, the same literary person, poet T.S. Eliot. Okay, his name, literary name, T.S. Eliot. We are going to learn about a biography of this poet T.S. Eliot. Is it clear to you? Fine. If so, I want to request you to read these things with me together. Okay? So we are going to learn a short biography, and later on you will know what is biography. Okay? Okay. Start reading together. First of all, you can listen to me, and then you can also read. Okay? The title for us is T.S. Eliot. You have to pronounce the name T.S. Eliot. See, the last name pronunciation is Eliot. We are going to learn about this person, the poet, and what sort of things are written in his biography. Let's go through. T.S. Eliot is a great American-born English poet, playwright, and literary critic. His full name was, now I think you are thinking, what is the full name of T.S. Eliot? What is his full name? Now, your answer is here. So, what was his full name? His full name was Thomas Stearns Eliot. Okay? In literature, in short form, he writes T.S. Eliot. Okay? So, his full name is Thomas Stearns Eliot. Now, here you can find the facts of this person. See, he is a great American-born English poet, and he is a playwright. You have to guess about the meaning of this word. Later on, I will discuss about it, okay? But you have to just think in this context. And a literary critic also. So these two highlighted words, you have to try to find out the meanings. Just guess, just think, okay? His full name was Thomas Stearns Eliot. He was born on, now tell me the date when he was born. What's the date here? Yes, you are right. He was born on September 26, 1888. Okay? In. And you have to tell me the name of place. Where was he born? The name of the place where he was born was Missouri. Two. Now, you have to tell me his parents' name. What are the names of his parents? Please tell me. Tell me the spelling also. Yes. H-E-N-R-Y, Henry. And then, Ware, W-A-R-E, Ware. And again, last name, Eliot. E-L-I-O-T, Eliot. And his mother's name? Okay, spelling C-H-A-R. Then, L-O-T-T-E, Salote. Okay, you have to pronounce as Salote. And then middle name, C-H-A-M-P-E, Champe. Okay, you have to pronounce as Champe. And last name is S-T-E-A-R-N-S, Stearns. So, from this paragraph, you have to find out three things. So, first question for you is, who was T.S. Eliot? Your answer? Yes, you are right. T.S. Eliot was a great American-born English poet. Okay? And you have to tell me, what was his full name? It was Thomas Stearns Eliot. Again, you are right. And another question for you. When was he born? You have to tell me the date. Yes, you are again right. He was born on September 26, 1888. And now, another information you have to know about him. And I have already told you, now you have to tell me the names of his parents. What was his father's name? Yes, again, you are right. His father's name was Henry Ware Eliot, and mother's name was Salote Champe Stearns. Okay, is it clear? So you know who was T.S. Eliot, you know where he was born, you know when he was born, then you know his parents' names. Okay, is that clear, all of you? Very good. Then we have another paragraph about him. So listen to me and try to read with me. Eliot took his higher education at Smith Academy, the Boys College Preparatory Division of Washington, University from 1898 to 1905. He studied Latin, ancient Greek, French, and German. He began to write poetry when he was 14. His first published poem was A Fable for Feasters. It was written as a school exercise and was published in the Smith Academy Record in February 1905. He studied philosophy at Harvard College from 1906 to 1909. He completed BA in 1909. And he completed BA in 1909 and MA the following year. The following year means in 1910. Okay. He had also worked as a philosophy assistant at Harvard from 1909 to 1910. By 1916, he completed his PhD from Harvard. So here you can find many information about T.S. Eliot. Okay. So first of all, before that one, I just like to ask you, because previously I told you that to make a guess of these highlighted words, meanings, okay? Playwright, critic, preparatory, philosophy. Now, first of all, let's practice the pronunciation of these words and then we'll discuss their meanings. So all of you, read the spelling. First, listen to me and read the spelling and pronounce, okay? Playwright, playwright. Now, all of you start together. Playwright, playwright. Once again. Playwright, playwright. Once again, pronounce it. Playwright. Okay, good. Another word we have is critic, critic. All of you together, okay? Critic, critic. Once again, please. Critic, critic. Very good. Another word we have, preparatory. So all of you listen and pronounce. Preparatory, preparatory. Once again, read together and pronounce. Preparatory, preparatory. Now, one more time. Preparatory, preparatory. Very good. Now, one more word we have here. Philosophy, philosophy. Once again, philosophy, philosophy. Once again, please. Philosophy, philosophy. Okay, so this is how you have to pronounce these words. Now, from this second paragraph, you have to answer me. I am going to ask you some questions because you have read with me and you have listened to me. So I want to ask you and you just try to tell me, okay? Now you have to tell me, where did he take his higher education? Where did he? Yes, you are right again. He took his higher education at Smith Academy, okay? Now tell me, what languages did we learn? Can you tell me the name of languages that T.S. Eliot learnt? What are they? Oh, yes, they are, once again, all of you tell me together, the languages are Latin, ancient Greek, French, and German. See how many languages? Latin, one, ancient Greek, two, French, three, and German, four languages. He learned four languages. Okay. And then you have to tell me the title of the poem that he wrote for the first time for his school exercise. What's the title of the poem? You are correct again. The title of the poem was A Fable for Feasters. You are right. Good. See, it was written as school exercise. He did not write it to publish in the newspaper, okay? His teacher assigned him to write, and he did that as his school exercise. So from there, his career, or you can say profession, started writing the poems. Is that clear to you? Well, then later on, what did he study? See, he studied philosophy. So you have to think the meaning of philosophy, okay? And you have to tell me, where did he study philosophy? Name of the college? You are right again. He studied at Harvard College. And you have to tell me the time. When did he learn philosophy at Harvard College? The date was, let's say, 1906 to 1909. And in 1909, what did he do? Yes, he completed his bachelor's level. He completed his BA, Bachelor's in Arts, you know. Then next year, he completed his Master's in Arts, MA, degree level, okay? So when did he finish his MA? You have to tell me the date, year. Oh, yes, so clever you are. He completed his MA in 1910, okay? Because in 1909, he completed his, let's say, BA. And then in the following year, means in 1910, he completed his MA, Master's Degree in Arts, okay? Then he had also worked as a philosophy assistant at Harvard from 1909 to 1910. Then he worked as a philosophy assistant at Harvard. And then later, he completed his PhD, okay? Philosophy in doctorate. Is that okay? Now, I want to discuss the meanings of these words because you might have already got the ideas. You might have already guessed the meanings of these highlighted words, playwright, critic, preparatory, and philosophy. So for it, playwright. So what's the meaning you have guessed? Please tell me. You can check your meaning. And for that, first of all, I want to show from the picture. Looking at this picture, you just make a decision whether you have guessed your meaning is right or wrong. So what is it? Your meaning is a person who writes drama or plays. Means writer who writes drama or play is a playwright. Okay? Now another meaning we have is critic. And what's its meaning? So first of all, I want to show you the picture. See, you can find one thumb down, another thumb up. It means that you might have guessed a person who tells about weaknesses and strengths, or a person who tells about negative points and positive points of something. So in a word, you can say commentator. Commentator, are you right? Well, another is preparatory. See, I want to show you the picture. Preparatory, it is related to education, okay? And your meaning should be relating to education in a prep school, okay? It's like beginning, you know, starting of education, preparatory. Now, another philosophy, a high-term word, and it means, this is the picture for you. And philosophy means, I know it is really difficult for you. And the meaning of philosophy is the study of the fundamental nature of knowledge, reality, and existence. Okay? So you can note down these meanings in your exercise book. I hope you might have finished writing these meanings in your notebook. Now, let's continue the remaining part of the text. See, we are again talking about T.S. Eliot, and we discussed so many things about his full name, about his date of birth, about his place of birth, about his parents, about his education, about his first poem, okay? Now, we are going to talk what happened in his childhood, okay? Okay, you also please read with me. He suffered from hernia in his childhood. His parents hired an Irish nurse to look after him. His nurse was a Catholic. This could have been a reason for his attachment and inclination towards Catholicism from his childhood. His writings are also deeply influenced by the biblical stories, myths, and its teachings from the very time he adopted Catholicism. So here, first of all, we are going to practice the pronunciation of these two highlighted words, and then I will ask you some questions based on this paragraph, and you have to tell me the answers. You try to understand yourselves, okay? And if you have any confusion, don't worry. I am here to support you. Let's practice. The first word here is hernia. H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. This R sound, R, R sound is silent here, okay? So you have to pronounce as H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. Once again, H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. Please practice it one more time with the spellings. H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. Very good. Now, another word we have here is inclination. So, let's read the spellings and practice pronunciation. I-N-C-L-I-N-A-T-I-O-N, inclination. Once again, I-N-C-L-I-N-A-T-I-O-N, inclination. One more time, please practice it. I-N-C-L-I-N-A-T-I-O-N, inclination. Now, you have to just guess the meanings of these words. Later on, we'll discuss and I'll give you. Now, before that one, I want to ask you a few questions based on this paragraph, okay? Now, you have to tell me the name of disease that T.S. Eliot was suffering from. What's the name of the disease? Oh, yes, you are right. The name of the disease was hernia. H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. See, you could make a guess that hernia is a name of disease. Perfectly correct. Okay, keep it up. And then, when you are suffering from this disease, hernia, whom his parents called there? Whom? Oh, again, you are very correct. His parents called Irish nurse. Do you know why nurse? Nurse is a profession here again. So, in our previous class also, we discussed the job of nurse. So, what is the job of a nurse? Yes, curing the patient, okay? So, his parents hired an Irish nurse to look after him because he was suffering from, well done, hernia, the disease, you know. Then, who was his nurse? Yes, again, you are right. His nurse was a Catholic. You know, in Christian community also, we can find two, let's say, branches. One is Catholic and another is Protestant. Okay? And his nurse belonged to Catholic community of the religion. Okay? So, she was a Catholic. And you have to tell me, why did he write the poems related to the, let's say, religion also, related to the Bible, biblical, you know, why he wrote such stories? Yes, you are again right. Because of Catholic nurse, he was, you know, inclined. He was attached towards Catholicism. So simply you can understand Catholicism is a branch of Christian religion, okay? Christianity, branch of Christianity. I have already told you that one is Catholic, another is Protestant, okay? So, he wrote the stories and some other things related to Catholicism. He was influenced by that community, okay, religion. His writings, Catholicism from his childhood, okay? He became a religious-minded person also. His writings are also deeply influenced by the biblical stories. Biblical means you have to understand related to the Bible, okay? The holy book of Christian community, okay? So his stories are related to Bible. Stories, myths, and its teachings from the very time he adopted Catholicism. Then he followed Catholicism. It means that when he wrote, at that time, he was influenced by this religion and he mentioned related to the Bible. Okay? That's what he did. And because of whom he did it? Okay, you are right. Again, because of his Irish nurse who was a Catholic. Okay. Now, I hope in this context, you might have already made a guess of the word inclination, meaning of the word inclination, because hernia, you have already told me that it's a name of disease, and then inclination. Now you can check your meaning with me. Hernia, of course, it is a disease, but what type of disease it is? See, if we have this type of problem, look at, I am pointing here, this type of problem, this is what we call hernia. Okay, so it is a condition in which part of an organ is displaced and protrudes through the wall of the cavity containing it. This is the name of disease. Now another inclination. Inclination means a person's natural tendency. It means that he started keeping his interest towards Catholicism. For example, after I teach you English language, if you keep your interest and you like to learn English language, then I can say that there is inclination in you towards English language. Okay? So, T.S. Eliot had also an inclination towards Catholicism because of Irish nurse who was a Catholic. Is that clear? Very good. Now, another paragraph again. See, we are talking about T.S. Eliot. Now here you can find what things he wrote, name of his writings are given here, and you're also given here, okay? So these are the facts done by T.S. Eliot. Let's read together. Eliot was one of the most influential poets of the 20th century. His writings brought a new wave in writing poetry. His first publication, The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock, is regarded as a masterpiece of the modernist movement. His other best-known poems in English language are Jeronson, it was written in 1920, The Wasteland, written in 1922, The Hollow Man, written in 1925, S. Wednesday, written in 1930, Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats, written in 1939, and Four Quartets, written in 1945. Okay, these are the names of the, let's say, poems written by T.S. Eliot. Okay, then he is also remembered as a great source of enlightenment in the light of religion for his seven plays, particularly Murder in the Cathedral, written in 1935, The Cocktail Party, written in 1949, and The Rocca Peasant play, written in 1934. Even he wrote the plays also, dramas also, okay? These are the names of dramas written by T.S. Eliot. He became successful to give new height to the English poetry and other forms of writing. Eliot was awarded both the Order of Merit and the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1948. So in this paragraph, you can find two information. One, about his writings. He wrote many poems. He wrote seven plays, okay? And the names of the poet given here and the name of the plays written by him given here. Not only that much, he was awarded with the prize. And those prize name also given in this paragraph. So before that one, I ask you some questions. Let's practice the pronunciation of the word masterpiece. Let's start. Read the spellings first and then pronounce it. masterpiece. Masterpiece. Once again, please. masterpiece. Masterpiece. Now, one more time. masterpiece. Masterpiece. Fine. Good. Now, I want to ask you a few questions. You have to tell me any two names of his poems. Oh, yes, you can write. You can tell, you can say any two names, okay? You can say that The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock, or you can say Jerusalem, or you can say The Wasteland, or you can say The Hollow Man, or you can say S. Wednesday, or you can say Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats, or you can say Four Quartets, okay? Any you can say. Similarly, you have to tell me any two names of the plays he had written. Yes, you can say that they are, let's say, Murder in the Cathedral and another, The Cocktail Party. Or you can say the Rocca Peasant Play. Okay. Now, another information you have to tell me about him. Please tell me the name of awards that he received in his life for the contribution he made for poetry. What are the names of the prizes he received? Oh, you are so smart. Very correct answer. They are Order of Merit and Nobel Prize. Okay? And when did he receive these prizes? Fine. It's very clearly given and you have already found it in 1948. Very good job you have done. Now, another last paragraph for us. Leaving a strong landmark in English poetry and stirring influence on modern English literature, T.S. Eliot passed away on January 4, 1965 in London. So here you have to find out his contribution made in the field of literature, and then it brought a kind of change, you know. It made a kind of movement in literature, and then finally he died on January 4, 1965 in London. Okay, so here are two more words. Let's practice the pronunciation. Start. Landmark. Landmark. Once again. Landmark. Landmark. Now one more time. Landmark. Landmark. Very good. Now another word is stirring. Stirring. Once again, stirring. Stirring. One more time, stirring. Stirring. Very good. Now you just tell me, when did he die? Well, you are absolutely correct. He died on January 4, 1965. Where did he die? Please. Of course, you are correct again. That was, let's say, London. He died in London. Very good. Now, meaning of masterpiece, you just check. See, Mona Lisa. Mona Lisa is a masterpiece of art painted by a famous artist, Leonardo da Vinci. Okay, so from the picture, you can make a guess of the meaning of the word masterpiece. That is an outstanding piece of work, extraordinary work, okay? Not normal type of work. You can write down these meanings in your notebook. Landmark, see, you can see picturization, and you can generate the meaning. That is an event marking a unique or important historical change. T.S. Eliot also made a great contribution to bring a change in poetry in English literature. Another stirring. See, you can understand as exciting, and it means a kind of movement, waving, you know. So because of him, there was a kind of, you know, a discussion. There was a kind of change in literature. All right? Now, after talking about T.S. Eliot, you have to find out the meanings of this word. person who writes drama or plays. I think it's very easy for you. We have discussed frequently. So what's its answer? You have to find out from the text. Yes, you are right. That is playwright. Okay. Another, an outstanding piece of work. What's the meaning of this word? I have just discussed about it. And the meaning of this word, tell me once again, loudly please, all of you together. All right, that is masterpiece, you know. Another word, followed. I hope you guessed the meaning of this word while reading the text. And the answer for this word is, tell me once again loudly. All right, this is adopted. Well done. And another number D, an event marking a unique or important historical change. We have just discussed. And you can surely tell it me. Now loudly tell me. I want to hear. Oh, yes, you are correct again. This is landmark. And the last word we have is he died in London. And what's the term used there, words used there for died? Oh, yes, you are so smart. That is passed away. Well done, my dear students. So after this, now again, I have one more exercise. Read the text again and complete the table about Eliot's life with correct information. You have to supply the correct information what happened in these years, 1888 AD, 1905 AD, 1909 AD, 1916 AD, 1948 AD, and 1965 AD. Please, you quickly write down what happened in his life. You can write only one word or two words, or if necessary, more words, no problem. But just write quickly, okay? And in your free time, you can write full sentence. Have you finished? Okay, now check. See what incident, what happened in his life in 1888? Oh, what is it? All right, it is T.S. Eliot was born. You could find it in the first paragraph. And what happened in 1905 AD? Oh, so smart. His poem of Fable for Feasters was written and published in the Smith Academy Record. Okay? And in 99 AD, what happened? Check. He completed his BA. Very good job. And in 1916 AD, what did he write? Please tell me. Please tell me loudly. All right. Again, you are correct. He completed his PhD from Harvard. Now, 1948, what happened in his life? See? Yes, Eliot was awarded both the Order of Merit and the Nobel Prize for Literature. He received two prizes, Order of Merit and Nobel Prize for Literature, for his contribution made in literature. Now, the last date given here, 1965, what happened? Oh my God, see? It was the last year in T.S. Eliot's life because he died. See, T.S. Eliot passed away. He died in this year. The world lost, you know, a great person from literature. All right? Very good job you have done. Now, another I have answered the following questions. I want to give you one model and rest of you can do at your home. See, where was T.S. Eliot born? For example, you can find in the first paragraph. See, T.S. Eliot is a great American-born English poet. And here is where. Where means place. And you can find, see, I have highlighted the word here, Missouri. Missouri is the name of place. And simply you can write down, he was, T.S. Eliot was born in Missouri. This is how you have to write down the answer. If you write only Missouri, your answer will be right. And if you can write down in complete sentence, that is better, okay? So if you write only in Missouri, also you are right. And like this, where did he take his higher education? You can find in the second paragraph these highlighted words, at Smith Academy, the Boys College Preparatory Division of Washington University. And you can write down like this, he took his higher education at Smith Academy, the Boys College Preparatory Division of Washington University. Dear students, this is how you can do rest of the questions given in your textbook, or you can write it down in your notebook. What problem did he face in his childhood? What made him inclined towards Catholicism? Okay. Another two more questions I have. What was Eliot's first publication? You have to write down the name of the poem, okay? List out the awards he got. He got two awards. You have to write down their names. Then, now, read the text again and make a list of Eliot's literary works. Now, this is your home assignment where you have to write down the names of poems, the name of plays given in your text. And I have given you like this one. And if you need some more numbers, you can add here 6, 7, 8, like that. This is your homework. Dear students, I hope you enjoyed our today's class and you might have better understood about T.S. Eliot and to-do comprehension exercises, and you might have got a little idea about biography. So from birth to death, if we write someone's life and activities, events, that is what we call biography. So this much for today. Keep practicing. Have a great day. Goodbye.